Hey guys, I'm Simatose Ken, and we're about to play the Stanley Parable. I actually thought that was Parable or something earlier. Anyway, I forget the name. Somebody's been leaving a lot of comments for me to play this game, send me a message and everything. I think it's been a few people. So I'm going to play it. I don't think it's horror. I don't think. It doesn't really say, but it's really high rated, so we're going to try it out. So let's start it. And I haven't even turned this thing on except for try to set the sound. I don't even know if the sound's set right or not. Click to skip.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Hello, Stanley.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor next to his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
I'm glad for
and
you,
then
Stanley.
One day, something very peculiar happened.
Ooh.
Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on a monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and walked out into the hallway.
Well, I did I? I'm a vampire! I can't see. I can't even jump. Can't do anything. Just walk. Okay. Is it too loud? I don't know. Not too bad if it is.
Stanley decided to go to the staff lounge to check on his co-workers. He never functioned well by himself and constantly needed support and guidance from others, so the thought of total solitude was terrifying to him.
Nobody's in there.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
I did. Okay. Wait, are you leading me the wrong direction, voice? I don't guess E does anything. Can you even click on anything? Hello?
As Stanley entered the lounge, he was horrified to find not a single person here. He decided he would walk up to see his boss, hoping that he would find an answer there.
Aha! Thank you. Hello?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Boss isn't here. Ooh, numbers.
Entering his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. It was at this point that he began to feel dizzy and a little sick, and even thought he might pass out when suddenly he noticed a keypad next to the filing cabinet in the corner of his boss's office. Stanley had never seen this panel before and had no idea what combination of numbers would produce any result. In fact, only Stanley's boss knew this, since the panel withheld access to the boss's greatest, darkest secret.
Oh, really?
And so he had assigned the keypad a combination that only he could possibly know. The number of his freshman dorm number in college. 1957. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
Of course. Okay. 1957.
Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. Stanley ventured forth into the newly opened passageway.
Amazing. I love this guy. I wish my voice sounded like that, actually.
As he drew deeper into the bowels of the building, Stanley had no idea where he was or what this place held. And just as he began to think he might not discover a thing, he emerged into a long room to find...
a lot of TVs.
Rows and rows of monitors. Screens with a number above it. Stanley noticed, however, that these were not random numbers, but the number of employees who worked in the building, his co-workers. Even his own number, 427, had a place on the wall. But why a setup so elaborate, he asked. Was this simple surveillance or something even more? And as if in answer to his question, the wall slid open before him, revealing the ultimate truth of the situation.
There's 18 workers here. That's counting. It's like, what does this do?
An enormous control panel, Stanley discovered, but not one that controlled simple machinery. Buttons were labeled with emotions. Happy. Sad. Levers and knobs controlled actions. Walking. Eating. Doing work. Or watching TV.
Oh, this.
Every input on this device monitored not the functions of a machine, but of a human being. And the reality began to sink in. Stanley, like so many other people, reduced to images on a monitor, had been under someone's control, always at the mercy of this machine. Could this have been the only reason employee number 427 was content with his boring job? That a machine had altered his emotions to accept it blindly? He began to feel an unbridled rage, and at the peak of his anger, something happened. A spark.
Oh.
Stanley looked up and saw the generator overhead, still providing some small amount of power to the machine, keeping it alive. And knowing that this generator was all that kept the controls running, Stanley moved to the ladder in the back of the room and began to climb towards the rafters.
Wait. You said that machine was controlling me, but now you're controlling me. Oh my gosh! I've fallen for it! Maybe, I don't know. Hey, I should have been walking up this already. This is a test!
The higher Stanley climbed, the closer he felt to freedom, the further from enslavement.
I think I'm enslaved to the nice sounding voice. Come on. Okay. Engage generator or disable generator. Just hold it, okay. Disabled, ho. What happened?
Blackness.
Yes.
Power gone. All alone. And then?
Don't you jump at me. Oh, that hit button scared me. Hello? Oh, there's. Oh! I'm an idiot. I could see the whole time. I was looking in the darkness. All right. Not bad.
As he stepped through the door into the fresh outside air, a feeling of liberation rushed through Stanley's body. He had seen power. He had seen enslavement. And he had destroyed it. The underling was in control now. He had found his leading role. Stanley never discovered why everyone had gone missing, nor how and when he had come under the machine's control. But it didn't upset him terribly, because he knew that this was how things were meant to happen. All he felt was a delight unlike any he had ever known before. Never again would he follow someone else's orders without question. Never again would anyone tell Stanley where to go, what to do, or how to feel. No more bosses, no more instructions on a screen. Stanley decides for himself now. And he stepped out into the world, and he felt the cool breeze upon his skin, and Stanley was happy.
Am I Stanley? Am I sitting here at my screen being told what to do? Are you telling me to go outside, game? We gotta go back. There's those other ways to go. There's questions that need answers. And so, with some editing, we're gonna try to get to those answers. Okay? Okay.